Good morning, everyone. I am Sankar Ganesh, Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Government College of Engineering, Bargur. Today, in this session, I will give a lecture on the topic of Introduction to Finite Element Analysis. So, what is FEA? So, Finite Element Analysis is a numerical technique which is used for solving complex engineering problems. So, which is used mainly in problems which involves complicated geometries, loadings and material properties in which analytical solution is not at all possible. So, for example, if you consider an engine block of an automobile, it is practically impossible to find out the temperature distribution of the block using conventional analytical techniques. So, by using this FEA technique, we can get the stress distribution or even temperature plot of the total block by using this FEA techniques. So, this FEA will reduce the number of prototypes and the number of experiments in the design phase, thereby reducing the product development to a larger extent. So, there is no need of real product for conducting experiments during the design phase. So, this FEA will require only 3D models which can be changed easily time by time. Thereby, the total product time will be reduced by a lot. FEA will give approximate solutions and the results should be confirmed using confirmation experiments or calculation. Yes, this FEA will give results for the whatever the input we give. So, if we give the wrong input, it will give the solution, but the result should be checked using confirmation experiments. So, where it is used? So, this FEA is used in mechanical, automobile, civil and aerospace engineering. So, automobile in the analysis of engine and cylinder, piston, everything. Then in the civil engineering, it is used in the design of bridges and the aerospace engineering for complete the Boeing, which uses CE tools for the complete design of the Boeing 777 aerospace parts. So, next in the case of fluid flow, for example, here this is a flow through a gate valve. This is a typical example of CE application in fluid flow. The heat transfer application. So there is a heat transfer through fins. Then biomechanics here. This is a example of the stress distribution on a knee due to the overweight on a knee. Then there are some other applications also, electromagnetic, acoustic, then all structural. So, the structural analysis may be linear or non-linear. Then, thermal analysis. So, what are the steps involved in FEAs? There are primarily three steps. First one is pre-processing, then processing and post-processing. So, pre-processing, in the pre-processing step, first you have to understand the nature of the problem. That is, whether the problem is thermal or structural, like that. Then, you have to select the appropriate element, then mesh the parts, then apply the boundary condition and the loading. These are the steps in pre-processing. The processing, you have to take the appropriate solver and the number of iterations. And in the post-processing, weaving and interpretation of the results and the preparation of reports. So first we go to pre-processing. So first step is to understand the nature of problems. There are different types of problems. So for example, if you look for a structural analysis, you get the stress distributions, the mode analysis, you get the frequency, then thermal analysis, like the buckling or linear non-linear analysis. So first we have to choose what type of analysis we need. Then second step is selection of elements. There are three types of elements, 1D element, 2D element and 3D element. So, the only element, there is a dimension in only one direction. The typical example is beam element. And 2D element, there is a plate or shell element. So, this is a plate element, this is a triangular element, triangular plate element. So, similarly, this is a 2D element, this is quadratic element. So, depending on the application, the type of element will be chosen. Then 3D element may be, it has three dimensions in X, Y and Z axis. So, example is, prism and hexagonal elements. So next step is meshing. So meshing is defined as the process of dividing the whole component into number of elements, so that when the load is applied on any of the component, any part of the component, it distributes the load uniformly to the all parts. Normally, this is a solid element. This is a solid model. This solid model is best using this. Here, there is a quadratic element is used. So, quadratic element is used for meshing the elements, meshing the model. So, these are the nodes. These are nodal nodes, and this is elements. These are elements. So, here the total complete solid model is meshed or discretized into number of elements, and each element having number of nodes. So again, during meshing, there are two important parameters to be checked. One is aspect ratio and another is skewness. Here aspect ratio is the ratio of longest edge to the shortest length. So aspect ratio for here, this is a triangular element, this is a good aspect ratio, this element has a good aspect ratio. While this is the same triangular element, this is a bad aspect ratio. The ratio of longest length to the shortest length is more in the case of this case. So this should be avoided. This is correct. Okay. So the aspect ratio should be minimum. The next important quality of mesh is skewness. So skewness means it determines how close to ideal a face or cell is. Okay. This is equilateral triangle. This is here. This is the correct or ideal equilateral triangle. So the skewness value of this is zero. So this is the best quality equilateral triangular element. So for this element, the skewness is less than 1, and this is highly skewed. So this type of element should be avoided. So similarly, this is a bad quality FEA mesh model which has high aspect ratio elements and also high skewness element. This should be avoided, and this is a good quality FEA model. So next step in post-processing is pre-processing is applying loads and boundary conditions. So boundary condition, for example, this is a cantilever beam with one end fixed. So while applying boundary condition, all the degrees of freedom and the displacement should be arrested in this region. So here displacement is zero and all degrees of freedom is zero. So like that, boundary condition should be applied. And also while applying load, there are three different loads: point load or concentric load. These are point loads. Point loads, these are point loads. Also there is surface load. There is this uniform distributed load is surface load. Then there are some other loads, this is temperature. Here, in this case, the loading condition is temperature. So these are the steps in pre-processing. The next come to processing. In processing, governing equations are assembled into matrix and summed numerically. So what are the inputs, boundary conditions and the loading condition you give? It will assemble into a matrix and it will automatically solve numerically. This is a general governing equation. K is equal to F. For example, if we conducting a structural analysis, this K is stiffness. This K is stiffness. So this is called stiffness matrix. And U is displacement and F is the force. This displacement is unknown. This is unknown. So this stiffness and the force is known. The governing equations are computed for each node, and the final displacement is calculated for each node. Final displacement is calculated for each node, and thereby we are getting the displacement of the total deflection of the beam or the part. Suppose if you consider the thermal analysis, this K is thermal conductivity and U is temperature and F is heat source. So the output is the temperature plot. So next is post-processing. So once the solution is done, the results should be interpreted and analyzed. The results should be interpreted and analyzed. So suppose if you are conducting a stress analysis, The result is, the output result is stress. The stress may be warm stress or principal stress. Suppose you are conducting thermal analysis, the result is temperature. So these are some of the results, stress, temperature, displacement, reaction. Suppose you are conducting frequency analysis or model analysis, the output result is frequency. So this is a output plot of a stress analysis of a Carting rod. So this is a mesh model and this is the output. So it was first result. This was the stress distribution over the Carting rod. So this is a general flow chart. So first, there are three phases: pre-processing, processing, and post-processing. The pre-processing, first we model, then we assign the material properties, then apply loads and conditions, and generate the mesh, and review the mesh, and give the mesh to the solver. And in the processing part, it will get solved, and the post-processing part, we are getting the results. This is the overall output. Thank you. Thank you, sir.